Every year, millions of people are bitten by venomous snakes, and good antivenom could help them. And with millions of sales, a good antivenom producer could stay in business even with a low price. But many hospitals in developing countries are not buying much antivenom, and so there's a shortage. What is wrong here? Consider Musa. He's a good man, healthy, supporting his family, until the day he is bitten by a snake. He goes to the hospital hoping for a cure. The doctors have only a small supply of antivenom, and it is very expensive. Musa's family must sell his animals to pay. The medicine does not work, but the doctors do not know why. Is it because it is damaged from heat, or the wrong kind, or perhaps even fake? Musa goes home disabled, poor, and not trusting the medical system. And he tells his community not to go to the hospital for snake bite. When his neighbors get bitten, they don't want to lose their life savings for no benefit. They go to the traditional healer instead, who doesn't use antivenom. They might not survive, but at least their families keep their farms. The hospital quits trying to buy antivenom. It costs too much, and it does not always work. And they never even hear about Musa's neighbors. With so few orders, the antivenom producers have to decide what to do. Should they just quit making it, raise the price, or cut corners on quality and safety? Different companies make different choices, which leaves the hospital paying a higher price for what might be poor quality or fake, even worse than before. When one bad thing leads to another like this, it's called a vicious circle. A vicious circle can go on for many years, and it's not simple to fix. If you fix just one piece, the other parts break it again. In fact, there is only one way to fix a vicious circle. You have to fix everything at one time. Here's how it all comes together. To ensure safer, higher quality antivenom, experts advise manufacturers about community needs. Epidemiology, local snake identification, temperature considerations, certification by government experts. To reduce the shortage, plenty of antivenom is distributed where it is needed. Government subsidies, large-scale purchases, shipping to all hospitals that need it. To improve patient outcomes, doctors and nurses are educated in the best possible snake bite care. Doctors' training, nurse training, local training, use of expert consultants. Snake-bitten people need to know that help is available and that they must get to the hospital quickly. Trust takes time to build. Community outreach and education, networking with local providers, and the increase in purchases of antivenom rewards the good companies. Sales go up, price goes down, quality manufacturers keep producing. The African Society of Venomology is doing this in 2017. In fact, the video you are watching is part of the solution. With improved information and communication, better products are becoming available. Heat stable, polyvalent, potent, pure, certified by ministries of health. Several countries have started subsidizing purchases and getting the antivenom where it is needed most. Subsidies, shipping, SAV-ASV members and faculty at colleges of medicine and nursing are teaching everyone they can. Lectures, conferences, publications, radio, this video series, community awareness. Building trust takes time, but already increased numbers of snake-bitten people are being treated in several countries. When you put all of this together, the result is called a virtuous circle. A virtuous circle has the potential to propagate over many years. This has happened in the past with snake bite and antivenom, in Mexico for example. Together, doctors, nurses, community educators, public health professionals, and manufacturers can turn Africa's vicious circle of antivenom shortage into a virtuous circle, and we can keep our people and their families healthy and happy.